Are operations still continuing at the site of this collapsed factory? Do you expect to find anyone else alive?
You see, we are trying our best to see if there is any live or dead bodies. So the government is working very sensitively and diligently so that if there is a live one, definitely it is welcome. My day started with the beautiful news that after 17 days, we get a live individual, Krishna, and maybe there could be more dead bodies, and the government is working very diligently and with a lot of sensitivity so that not a single dead body could be mutilated.
How many people are still missing, Ambassador?
So far, the good news is we have rescued 2,438, including today's one, and these are live, 2,438 live. And then we have also got the dead bodies of around 1,036.
And how many do you know still missing?
Excuse me?
How many people do you believe are still missing?
I don't know. We don't know because we have no record of how many were working on that day at that time in the building.
All right.
So we don't know. But well, I don't think there would be too many more because majority has been taken care of.
All right. Let me ask you about the committee that your government established in the days following this disaster to try and identify areas in Bangladesh and in Bangladeshi law to try and improve the situation for Bangladeshi workers. To what stage has that committee now reached? Where is it at in terms of its findings and its recommendations?
You see, after the incident, that accident, government has, this has really basically is a awakening call for the country. And government has taken a number of steps. Some has been implemented.
Let me ask
as
about
you know,
the committee specifically.
There has been, pardon?
Let me ask about the work
pardon?
Of the committee specifically in terms of changing Bangladesh's laws to make its safety program complied with by factory owners.
You see, the factory owners, the government has already closed down 18 factories which they thought they are not very, you know, safe and secure. And the factory owners have come forward to improve their condition. So we have a now tri-party arrangement. The factory owners, the government, and international organization working together to ensure that such bad things never happen again.
Let me bring in my colleague Christiane Amanpour, who spoke with the Prime Minister of Bangladesh last week. As you know, Sheikh Hasina defended your government's response to the disaster, but also said, as you mentioned there, about international companies coming to Bangladesh for cheap labour and her view of what she believes they must do. And I'll come back to you afterwards for a comment, please.
Listen, if they want to do business, this buyer, they also consider they should increase the price of the garments so that the business can run properly and the labor can get good salary. So they are also partly responsible for it.
What progress, Ambassador, has been made so far with international companies?
You see this there's so many people have been responsible. We have our own lapses for the years, and we did not do our part of the job, that's true. And this is an issue, you see. Now, it's beyond who, I should not be worried about the blame game, because we shouldn't go into the blame game. But what we want to do is, we have to work all together and to find out that their position could be improved and there cannot be any more in safety problems.
And what assurances have you got from international companies? What assurances have you got so far for the 3.6 million
you
workers?
See, we found there is a large number of international companies because if they stay in Bangladesh, it is a win-win situation for all. And naturally, we have to improve our situation. But at the same time, I believe that we can do a job together. I would like to remind you, in many years ago, there was allegations of child labor in Bangladesh, you know, garment factory. And then Bangladesh government, the BGMA, the US State Department, US Commerce Department, the ILO, we worked together. And in the process, we resolved that issue in a very beautiful way.
Okay.
Maybe here, we have to work together to resolve this problem
and
in an ideal way.
Obviously, but finally, where do you expect to see the garment industry in your country in a year from now?
I think it will continue to grow, and we will continue to improve the situation, and we'll retain the confidence of the global community. And it would be a win-win situation for all, both the buyers and the sellers, and for particularly for the laborers.
Dr. Momin, we must leave it there. Thank you for joining us from New York.